I'm gonna try to keep this brief, but I don't need anything from any of you. Mick, day one, they put a leadership necklace around your neck. I go 39 days struggling to find a reason that you deserve that title. You did nothing. You did nothing with your team. You did nothing to encourage them. Nobody on that team had any guts. You're responsible for that. Russell, this hurts me. We had nothing in common. You played an unethical game, admittedly played an unethical game. The crazy thing about it is, you're sitting there, I'm standing here. Did you get to the right place by behaving the wrong way? I've never been in a situation in my entire life where that was the case. But you sit there proud of it. Natalie, people will call you weak. People will say that you are undeserving. But you know what? Why are those characteristics any less admirable as lying, cheating, and stealing? Why does he get a free pass, but your wrong way of playing is admonished? If there's one thing that I learned in this game, it is that perception is not reality. Reality is reality, and you are sitting there, and that makes you just as dangerous as any one of those guys there. You would say that you were probably the least deserving of the title of Soul Survivor. But maybe, just maybe, in an environment filled with arrogance, delusional entitlement, maybe the person who thinks that she's least deserving is probably the most. You got my vote. I hope you get four more. Congratulations.
I have no questions. I just have statements. Rich, you are a very openly arrogant, pompous human being. But I admire your frankness with it. You have worked hard to get where you're at, and you started working hard way before you come to the island. So with my work ethic background, I give that credit to you. But on the other hand, your inability to admit your failures without going into a whiny speech makes you a bit of a loser in life. Kelly, the rafting persona queen, you did get stomped on national TV by a city boy that never swam, let alone been in the woods or a jungle or rode a boat in his life. You sucked on that game. Anyways, I was your friend at the beginning of this, really thinking that you were a true friend. I was willing to be sitting there and put you next to me. At that time, you were sweeter than me. I'm not a very openly nice person. I'm just frank, forward, and tell you it the way it is. Have you sit there next to me and me lose $900,000 just to stomp on somebody like this? But as the game went along and the two tribes merged, you lied to me, which showed me what the true person that you are. You're very two-faced and manipulative to get where you are at anywhere in life. That's why you fail all the time.
Interesting.
So at that point of the game, I decided then just to go out with my alliance to my family and just to hold my dignity and values in check and hoping I hadn't lost too many of them and play the game just as long as possible and hang in there as long as possible. But Kelly, go back to a couple times Jeff said to you, what goes around comes around. It's here. You will not get my vote. My vote will go to Richard. And I hope that is the one vote that makes you lose the money. If it's not, so be it. I'll shake your hand and I'll go on from here. But if I were ever pass you along in life again and you were laying there dying of thirst, I would not give you a drink of water. I would let the vultures take you and do whatever they want with you with no ill regrets. I plead to the jury tonight to think a little bit about the island that we have been on. This island is pretty much full of only two things, snakes and rats. And in the end of Mother Nature, we have Richard the snake, who knowingly went after prey, and Kelly, who turned into the rat that ran around like the rats do on this island, trying to run from the snake. I feel we owe it to the island's spirits that we have learned to come to know, to let it be in the end the way Mother Nature intended it to be, for the snake to eat the rat.
Tony, when I first showed up, you and I, first day, became the best of buddies, and we were on the bottom of the alliance, instant friends. And you know what? We started to share intimate stories. Now you sit here now, and you would not be sitting there if I didn't have a big part in it. Because nobody here ever, for one second, trusted you. They trusted me. And I had to convince them all to trust me, to trust you. And I spent the entire game putting out little flames for Tony. So you could sit there, and you came to me in your paranoia, and you said, I'm telling you, man, something's going wrong here. I said, Tony, take a chill pill, relax. I'm here for you. I'm never gonna leave you. And you said, I need to know that for a fact. I said, well, don't be swearing on your mother and your kid. You've already done that for everybody else. Find something different. And you looked right at me, and you said to me, I will swear on my father's grave. I've lost two siblings. And those two losses have put two holes in my heart that could never, ever be repaired. I would never, ever, ever have gone back on the promise of my brothers. Not today, not tomorrow, not for $100 million, not for anything. I have $1 million question for you that I want you to answer to your mother, to your wife, Marissa, to your daughter, Anastasia. Was it worth it to you for $1 million to sacrifice your own father to get you here? Was that worth it to you?
Trish, I was outnumbered when Wu came up to me. He had Spencer, he had Tosh.
I asked you a question. I don't want excuses. I'm saying to you, heart to heart, friend to friend, human being to human being, answer the question. Is it worth it to you to be here, to play a game for $1 million on your father's soul and memory? Yes or no? It's a $1 million question.
Yes.
Thank you.